Thank you, oh my Father, oh for giving us your Son.
Before we start our devotion, we'd like to pray, thanking God for our lives, thanking God for giving us the opportunity to see each other's face. We are thanking God for our families. We are thanking God for His goodness and for His mercies. Let us lift up a voice of gratitude into heaven. Wherever you are seeing us, wherever you are watching us, just thank God. We are thanking you, Jesus. We thank you for giving us life. We thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your mercies. We thank you, Heavenly Father God, that we are not consumed. When we are counted among the living this day, it's just by your grace. We thank you for our families. We thank you for our church. We thank you, God. Even for our enemies, Heavenly Father God, may Heavenly Father God, your protection be so strong upon us. Continue being our Father. Continue being our protector as you've always been. We are thanking you, Jesus God, for whatever you are about to do. He said, everything we should lift up a voice of thanksgiving unto you, God. So we thank you even for the good, we thank you for the bad, God. We thank you and continue thanking you because you deserve every bit of our gratitude this morning. Amen. We thank you so much for making it a point to be with us this morning. We are continuing today's devotion from where we ended yesterday. Now, this week has been, is the wicked week, and many men of God have talked about the theme for this week, and we are just going to take something little from it. The theme for the week is being grounded in Christ. Say, at the end of the day, you know, every youth man will be tintin with Jesus Christ, and women, Bible, and will be around. So, be tintin, it doesn't matter what goes on around you, you shall be firmly established in Christ. And you see, and now it's just so it will be here, and right, it's we should be aware of the philosophers and the eminios in our lives. So we are continuing from that place, and today we are going to talk about the path to getting grounded, the path to getting grounded. Choir, I'm a fasua, team, for Jesus Christ to move. And our main text is being taken from the text for the team, Colossians chapter 2, verse 6. Colossians chapter 2 verse 69, and I read from the New King James Version, and I read, as you therefore have received Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk in Him, rooted and built up in Him, and established in the faith, as you have been taught, abounding in it with thanksgiving. Praise God. This was part of the letter written by Paul to the church in is a small church being founded by a servant of God and a disciple of Paul by the name Epaphras. So Epaphras was giving an account of the church to his master Paul. And Paul, realizing or seeing the faith of the church, decided to write this letter. In fact, Paul was with his son Timothy in prison. Paul was in prison in Rome. So he decided to write this letter to the church. What I want to tell us as youths is that no matter the situation that we find ourselves, we should not relent on preaching the gospel. Paul was in prison, but he made it a point to preach the gospel to the church in Colossae. So wherever you find yourself, make it a point to preach the gospel. Amen. So Paul wrote this letter to the church in Colossae, making them aware that he, Paul, has read in the letter about their faith in Christ, And this faith, he has also read that this faith has resulted in their love for the saints. So he was trying to tell them that they should keep on doing the good work that they want to and me. What you say, one did they think to more Jesus Christ to move? That's how did they also? I'm a baby, our friend or daughter, they do move here. One person when you say, Juman, it's you know, a catcher one said, one young community. Me, Paul, I am Paul. When I go on my knees, I keep praying for you. And there was three prayers that Paul kept on praying for the church in Colossae. And I pray that this prayer shall be our portion as youth. As we walk throughout this week with the thing in our head, and as we walk throughout this week, try to appropriate what we shall be taught, that this prayer shall manifest strongly in our life. The first prayer that Paul prayed for the church in Ephesus was that he was asking God to fill them with the knowledge of his will in all wisdom and spiritual understanding. It is my prayer that as youth, as we are going through this week, and as we are trying to learn about how we are going to be grounded, we shall be filled with God's wisdom and spiritual understanding. This is what we need in times like this, because a lot of teachings are going around. People are saying so many things that want to shift our focus from Christ. But if we are being filled with God's wisdom and understanding, we shall not be deceived by these things. Also, Paul was also praying and telling God to give them the grace to walk worthy of him, and also to fully please him, God. So this is our prayer, that we shall be given the grace to walk worthy of the Lord. And whatever we do, we shall fully please God, and we shall be fruitful in all good work. And so we say, Bibi Piara, you know, as Israel, baby, as anybody that said, you who be doing him, say we are the salt of the world. It is a sign that we show no one that na me. So soon they said they do be there. And also he was trying to tell God to also strengthen the church and the believers in all might. This is my prayer for you. So after these prayers that Paul told the church that was praying for them, he taught them about also the divinity of Jesus Christ, trying to establish and telling them about who Christ really was. But in all this, there was something worrying Paul about the church, and he decided to make the church know about these things. When you read chapter 2, boy, you could see that Paul was trying to tell the church about the false teachings and the persuasive ways which were infiltrating the church. And these things are relevant in our times as youth. We have a lot of teachings going about the New Age movement, secular humanism, teachings that are trying to shift our focus from Christ. But I pray that after today's devotion and throughout this week's teaching, we shall realize these teachings and we shall be grounded in Christ. Look at my sin. What? And we now actually at this family, young, and even by our soul, one shall share away moon, and let's let him think when Jesus Christ to move. And to Paul, a culture on near a Kawasha, and Church, a Kawasha, and you know, he provided a solution. A good leader is supposed to provide a solution. So Paul provided a solution. That is what we read in our main text, chapter 2, verse 6. And as you therefore have received Christ, so Paul was trying to enlist some four basic things the church can do to be grounded. So first of all, he said, you have to receive Christ. You have to receive Christ. Praise God. So he was trying to announce Christ to the church. It's the same thing we are trying to do to you, whoever is watching us this morning, that wherever you are, if you've not received Christ, this is the time for you to receive Christ. Because if you've not received Christ, you can't be grounded. So when Jesus come on and the Alpha and Omega, who cried and cried, who didn't think to win him? Back on the chest, you were Romans chapter 10, verse 9 to 10. Us with the hearts, we receive unto righteousness. With the hearts, we receive on with the mouth, we confess unto salvation. We be pay one can say, yes, you please to a young upon back. I know now here. Up can pay no conqueror of it now. Until this is the first step of receiving Christ Jesus. Say, we pay one can up on the action now. I can't have it now. I am a body for praise God. Until he told them about the first step that they should have to receive Christ Jesus, which the church has already received, because they were termed or they were called Christians. If you're a Christian, then you are supposed to be someone who have already received Christ Jesus. So the second thing he was telling them, that so walk in him. Walk in him. It is worrying that we have a lot of Christians who say they receive Christ Jesus, but they don't walk in Him. If you are walking in Christ Jesus, it means that you are forgetting about things of the past. Niamana, ayam bonena, ufi mubai, umkong kofabiyem. Bible called Galatians chapter 4 verse 16 say, we should walk in the spirit that will not gratify the desire of the flesh. Then number one, say it mean the way we are psychologists. Then Bible says it is about for Jesus Christ to empty. Now we saw not to anyone. It's never now yet the masturbation, the fornication, the lesbianism, homosexuality. We are supposed to walk away from those things, and we're supposed to walk in Christ Jesus because you have the Holy Spirit to help you. So this was the second step that Paul was trying to tell the church. And the third one was that they should build up in Him. They should build up in Him. If you are building yourself up in Christ Jesus, then that means you are coming to the level that you become like Him. You are coming to the level that people will see you, and they will see the nature of Christ in you. You are coming to the level that they will see the beauty of Christ in you. We can find out in Galatians chapter 4 verse 22 to 23. The fruit of the Spirit needs to be demonstrated in your life, and it takes a conscious effort, daily devotion, daily prayer, daily fasting, daily study of the word. Daily prayer is what you need for you to be built up in Christ Jesus. And the last thing that Paul talked about was to be established in him. So these are the first step that he talked about, to be established in Him. At this level, you have the completeness of Christ in you. When you're established in Him, by which you have the completeness of Christ in you. And Christ being the Godhead who has power over power and principalities, that Christ is in you. At this level, there's no way storms can blow you away. We have a lot of storms going around our streets. In our world, we have the storms of even coronavirus, we have the storms of disease, we have the storms of life, poverty, our storms, challenges that you are facing. But when you're established on the rock, which is Jesus Christ, there's no way these storms shall blow you anyhow. So this, at this point, even the Bible, what the Bible says in Ephesians chapter 3 verse 10 becomes very meaningful. He says the essence or the intent of God for the church is that what the manifold wisdom of God shall be made known to the principalities and powers. The wisdom of God is Christ Jesus. Christ Jesus is the power and the wisdom of God. And if Christ Jesus lives in you, through you, He will make the manifold wisdom of God to be made known to principalities and powers. And through you, you shall be able, or God shall be able to draw souls unto Himself. We thank you for making it a point to be with us this morning. It is my prayer that you shall be grounded. It is my prayer that through you, Christ Jesus shall win souls. Your lifestyle shall demonstrate that of Christ. People will see and run to Christ for salvation. God will you bless you at this point. I want us to pray about what we just heard. Paul makes some prayers to the church. We are praying that may God grant us divine wisdom and understanding into His word. Wherever you are, let's lift up a voice as a youth that you need divine wisdom, divine understanding into the things of God at this time. We are praying for divine wisdom. We are praying for understanding in this time, God, that we shall not be taken by surprise by any devices of the enemy. In the name of Jesus, we are also praying for the entire church. We are praying for the entire world that in these times of coronavirus, may we be strengthened in all minds. May we be strengthened in all minds. May we be shielded from any disease. May we be shielded from any things of the enemy, all the things the enemy has planned for us. In the name of Jesus, let us pray, committing the church, the entire youth, into the house of God, that in these times of coronavirus, may God strengthen us. In the name of Jesus, strengthen us, God. Strengthen us, God. Strengthen us in times like this. Strengthen us in times like this. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you for your word. We thank you, God, for admonishing us this morning in the name of Jesus. At this moment, if you've not accepted Christ, and I'll buy Jesus Christ to my message, I come from Israel. And here, if you want to be grounded in Christ Jesus, you need Christ. So I just want to help you and lead you to Christ wherever you are. You just say these things after me. At the end of the day, before Jesus Christ to send me cry, and imagine one. We did to myself. We want to know where we really want to also be. It's an empty. The Father said, we're not going to be able to do it. Amen. So what are some Yamaya? Or the end of the bar? So you are now.